يفنى الكل ويبقى هو، ليس الباقي إلا هو. الله 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 الله، ما لي رب إلا هو.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حدثنا أبو اليمان قال ثنا شعيب قال ثنا أبو الزناد عن الأعرج عن أبي هريرة أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: والذي نفسي بيده لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده. سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه narrates that Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, by him in whose hands is my life, none of you will have complete faith till he loves me more than his parents and his children. My dear brothers in Islam, what do we learn from this hadith sharif? The first thing that we learn is what is iman. Complete iman is complete and total love for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. If one wants to measure his iman or to check the state of his iman, then one should ponder and think that when it comes to the respect and the status of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, then what is his reaction? When somebody says words which are not befitting the blessed status of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, or when one comes across such people who have disrespectful beliefs towards the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and about the status of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, then what is his course of action? What is his reaction? From this, one can understand and one can measure and recognize the state of his or her iman. If one is ready and prepared to sacrifice everything at the feet of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in the way the blessed companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in did, then he should know for sure that my iman is strong and complete, like the strong and complete iman of Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. If one looks at the reaction and actions of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when wealth were needed, then Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu didn't leave anything at home. He brought all his wealth and sacrificed it at the feet of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. He did not even leave the needle or the thread at home. When it came to his life, he was prepared to sacrifice his life and to take on the whole of Arabia in the love of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. When it came to his home, he sacrificed his home. He left his place of residence, Makkatul Mukarramah, and out of love for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he traveled to Madinatul Munawwar. When it came to his children, we have all heard the famous incident about his conversation with his son when Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu said that, O son, when you were against me in battle, if you had come under my sword, I would have not stopped my sword and I would have sacrificed my own son at the feet of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So when we believe and when we love the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, we have been instructed to love and believe the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in such a strong way, in the same way as the blessed companions loved and believed in Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And this is siratun mustaqim. The other thing what we learn and what is clear from this hadith sharif is that complete iman is that iman in which the person does not reject the faza'il, the khasa'is, the specialities and the higher status of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because when one loves somebody and when one loves the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he loves and he believes the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam to be the most afdal, the most a'la, the most perfect, the most unique in every single aspect. Whether it's beauty, whether it's his status, his maqam, whether it's his knowledge, whether it's his ability and power given by Allah Almighty, whether it's his nuraniyat, whether it's his blessed characteristics, his blessed personality, in every single aspect, the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is the most perfect, the most unique, and the best of all creation. And the other thing which we learn from the hadith sharif is the difference between a mu'min and a munafiq, a believer, a true believer, and a hypocrite. The true believer's heart is full with the love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His heart, his actions, his words, or full of respect for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam, whereas the heart of a munafiq and the actions of a munafiq and the words of a munafiq are completely empty of the respect of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. If we look at some of their beliefs, you will be able to understand how their actions, how their beliefs and how their words are completely void of respect for Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. When they say that the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam is just like us, he's just a normal human being. When they say that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam does not have the knowledge of the unseen, he cannot tell what's going to happen tomorrow, where is he going to reign, he does not have any superior ability than any normal human being, he does not have the ability from Allah Almighty to change something which is haram to halal and which is halal to haram. So when somebody says that the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam is just like us, he is completely rejecting all of the specialities, all of the status, all of the abilities and the maqam of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam, which has been granted by Allah Almighty. So we must protect ourselves and keep ourselves well away from such people and keep them away from us also. Keep well away from them and keep them well away from you, because the foundation and the basis of complete iman is the complete and total respect and love for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. And this is a sign of having complete iman. The munafiqs accept with the tongue that the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam is the Prophet, but there is no love and no respect in the heart. When we talk about love for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam, the signs of true love for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam, that when we love the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam, we love him in such a way that we truly believe with our heart that there is none other like him in every single aspect. A sign of true love for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam is when we hear about his specialities, about his characteristics, about his traits, about his sunnah, about his description, then we feel complete happiness. When we hear about the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam, we feel coolness and peace and contentment in the heart. When we hear his name, we become happy. It gives us joy just by merely hearing his name. And when somebody loves somebody, truly loves somebody, he spends his night and day speaking about the blessed maqam, speaking about his uniqueness, speaking about his perfection, speaking about his husna jamal, speaking about his miracles, speaking about his traits. And if you look at all of the sects, somewhere or another, are void of respect for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. The only sect, the only way and group of those who fully and totally respect and love the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam is the path of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And in today's day and age, which is known as Maslaki Ala Hazrat Azim Barkat radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, Allah Almighty always keep us firm upon the Maslaki Ala Hazrat Azim Barkat radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and may we be granted true love for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. Ki raza aaj gali suni hai, uth mere dhoom machane wale, wa ma'alena illa al-balagh al-mubin.